Jai Shri Krishna, Jai Shri Ramachandra, Jai Shri Lakshmi Nrisimha. So today I'm going to talk about the world, the future of the world, and what will happen from November 20th, 2020 to November 2021. So the content of this video was banned twice by YouTube. When I put it back in April, in the first few days of April, it was removed by YouTube just after 1 month and 16 days after it had crossed 1.5 million views. And once again, when I re-uploaded it, it was again deleted by YouTube after it just crossed 700k views in just 3 or 4 days. So my dear friends, this is a very important video, and the big tech and maybe the elite also do not want us to know what's going to happen in the future and what the planets can and how the planets can affect us for the coming months. So according to astrology, starting November 20th, 2020 to November 2021, I'm going to explain all the planetary positions that are important and that can cause harm, and where we should be careful and what we can do. But if there are any extra things like eclipses, I'll make separate videos when time comes for them. But at the moment, we're going to discuss about the most important stuff in this video. But before I begin, I would like to caution you all that this video is incomplete, and the second part of this video is vitally important, and it's extremely important for you all to watch that one before making any conclusion, and that has the key to what we must do during this time to avoid any danger. It is important for the whole world, and maybe thus it has been banned by YouTube. So please watch that video in the and the link to which has been provided in the description box, and the second part will be put only on our Awaken Conscience channel, which is a different one. The one that you're seeing will be put on the Conscience channel, and you will find the second part and the first part both in our other channel, Awaken Conscience, which is made specially for videos that are highly controversial and susceptible to removal by YouTube. So again, I would like to tell you all that if you would like to share this video or any of my predictions with anyone, please do not share just this video, but the second part of it also, as that is extremely important. And if only the first one is shared, it could result in misinformation. And if anyone is able to translate these videos into other languages, which is also a very important thing, you could do it directly in the settings of this YouTube video below, and you could make the translations and put it on as subtitles to this video. And anyone who wants to listen and understand this video in that particular language can choose that in the settings below, and if it is present, you can use it, or else we'll think of other ways to get it out, or also it might not be possible at the moment. So you could watch this entire video, and before commenting also, I request you all to watch the complete video. That means the first portion, what you're hearing now, and the second portion that will be present in certain platforms. And if YouTube bans it, as it has done many times before, twice before, this particular video, it was put as a 41-minute video, it was banned without any proof, and it had not violated any community guideline, yet it was removed by YouTube, and you can also watch the video detailing that. But at the moment, I would like to talk about mainly the highlights of this prediction, so that it is not highly controversial yet vitally important for YouTube to remove it. YouTube has a very strong policy to police important content that is important for the people to take action and to delete it before people get to know what's going to happen. We shouldn't be caught unawares, and that is the main reason, the root reason for me making this video. We shouldn't be caught by some dangerous disaster unawares. It could be any particular disaster. At the moment, it may seem just like a particular global disease. It could be an economic destruction, it could be war, it could be disease. But let's get into each one of these details and find out what exactly could it be, and how can we guard ourselves against it, and what are the main dates of which we all have to be careful. This is not meant to fearmonger, as it will be evident in the next few minutes. It is very important to understand that this video is meant to bring in awareness about the future to the public, so the public is able to take action. We have only 4 months left to strengthen our immunity, to develop our economy, at least the basic stage of the economy, and do something that can guard us from the dangers of the future. So starting November 20, 2020, Jupiter will enter into the sign Capricorn, its debilitation point. And after this, Jupiter and Saturn will get conjunct in what is infamously known as the Great Conjunction on December 20th and 21st, 2020, depending on the location, in the sixth degree of Capricorn, which had happened just in March and April, that is the last days of March and the first days of April. And this was one of the most important things which struck me back in August 2019 when I made the prediction about the present situation. So the same particular situation is getting reiterated again in the same degree, the sixth degree, but this time in a more powerful way with the two planets, Jupiter and Saturn. Jupiter and Saturn, whenever they get conjunct, they have been shown to be causing mass disaster and danger, and a lot of trouble also. So this time is 2020, December 21st and also December 20th. It's very important for us to understand that these two planets are getting the closest conjunction in 400 years. The last time they were so close was in the sign of Capricorn on July 16, 1623. That is nearly four centuries ago. And it's very important for us to understand that at that time it was in the sign of Cancer, but now it is very powerful in the sign of Capricorn. So let's get into the details and understand how this can affect us. Last time again, there was one more great conjunction, as it is called formally, between these two planets in the same sign 59 years ago, that is 1961, and we know what happened just 1 year after that and what was brewing in that year. But as far as now, we know that just before December 21st, just 1 week, exactly 7 days before this, we have one total solar eclipse that is taking over the area of the southern South America, and you can watch it live on that particular day. It is going to be visible in Chile and Argentina, and that also has significance to those particular areas. But one very important thing is that this particular eclipse is not that important as the subsequent great conjunction. And now I'm going to just check my notes on this if I've missed anything. But of course, it's very important to watch the second part of this video. Yes, so at the moment we have a weak global immunity. Of course, due to overexposure of technological devices and overall technology and disconnection from nature at the same time, not only nature but even our loved ones and everyone, the whole humanity is staying away from each other due to the fear of viruses. And now soon we will start getting scared of each other also. And this is confidently called the post-COVID-19 world. It's going to be disastrous, where humans fear humans, and that will, if not taken care of, be one of the reasons of the destruction of our very human civilization in the humanitarian aspect. We might still be living as transhumanists, but we will be disconnected from nature completely. And it's very important for people to understand this and watch the latter part of this video. We all need to have faith in God at this time. We need to stop spreading fear. Rather, we need to start spreading hope, because we are in a particular situation wherein there's a lot of fear. It's more than a pandemic of a virus, it's a pandemic of fear. And this fear is more dangerous than the virus itself. And fear is nothing but false evidence appearing real. And now I'm going to talk about this particular topic and why we should prepare for the future. as our immunity is already weak, sitting at home, and we are very susceptible to new diseases that we have never come across earlier. I'm going to talk about that, and also I'm going to make two more videos, one on the importance of nature and how we should be valuing nature and what we can do to in fact, people who live in natural atmosphere have a 34% lesser risk of any disease that kills us from the respiratory system, and that has been published in the Harvard University research, and I'm going to make a separate video on that also. And it also cures depression, which is a major reason to reduce our immunity, which in turn can be a cause of respiratory disease related mortality. So with this, I end the first part of the video, and I again request you all to watch the second part, which is extremely crucial. So thank you.